top 10 most haunted places in New England. Hello viewers, welcome to another exciting edition and thanks for watching. Today we shall be talking about the top 10 most haunted places in New England. Have you ever wondered what it's like waking up to a nightmare or walking on lonely streets with the thought of being trailed? Not in any way intending to shake you off your boots, but that's right, buckle up, because ghost stories are rampant in most parts of the world and the United States is not exempted. New England is a small area compared to the rest of the United States, but it is rich with history and culture. From the Native American tribes to the Revolutionary War, the area provides a great learning experience, but besides the history, the area is filled with many ghostly locations. If you are new here, well then, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and turn on post notifications so you don't miss any of our amazing uploads. Without any further ado, and in no particular order, here are the top 10 most haunted places in New England, United States. Number 10, America's Stonehenge. Throughout the area, one can find some interesting tourist spots. This roadside oddity in Salem, New Hampshire, consists of 30 acres of stone structures and large rock formations which are claimed to go back as far as 40,000 years. While who built these structures and why remain a subject of debate, the area is said to be home to shapeshifting ghosts. Many claim that some of the rocks in the area would transform into spirits of Native Americans and other people. Spooky, right? Number 9, the Sterling Opera House. From music to speeches, the Sterling Opera House in Derby, Connecticut hosted various class acts such as the likes of Bob Hope, Amelia Earhart, and Harry Houdini. Built in 1889, the building currently showcases an array of ghosts, with one ghost being a young boy named Andy. These particular spirits like to move items, such as a ball, around the stage area. In 2011, the location was featured on the television show Ghost Hunters. Number 8, Blood Cemetery. Cemeteries are claimed to be a hotbed of ghosts. Located in Hollis, New Hampshire, the cemetery's actual name is Pine Hill. It earned the name Blood Cemetery not for any creepy reason, but for the prominent family that is buried here. Many ghosts are claimed to reside here. Numerous panorama researchers have visited this location and have captured voices on recordings and strange anomalies in pictures. Number 7. The Payne House. Colonial America survives well in New England, both in terms of architecture and the spirits that still roam. Built around the 1740s by Francis Bacon, the house is now a museum and historical society in Coventry, Rhode Island. One of the most active spirits is that of a young girl. Investigations conducted here have captured EVPs and strangle occurrences on video, such as a rocking chair moving by itself. Number 6, Rutland Prison Camp. Abandoned places can be creepy, and this old prison camp is no exception even for ghosts. It was built in 1903, but closed in 1934 with only a few structures still standing, like the root cellar and solitary confinement. A nighttime visit here can be very spooky, filled with odd noises and moving shadows. One ghost is said to be the wife of a former warden that is seen wandering near the ruins of the warden's house. Number 5. College Hall. Higher education can expand your mind but also frighten you. Vermont College of Fine Arts in Montpellier started as a seminary in 1831 before becoming a college in 1941. The most haunted location on campus is College Hall, which is said to be haunted by a girl who may have been murdered there. She has a habit of playing the pipe organ in the chapel area. Number 4. Captain Grant, 1754. There are many haunted bed and breakfast establishments in the USA, and this one in Preston, Connecticut is no exception. Named after Captain William Grant, who lived there with his wife Mercy, the inn is said to have many spirits and ghosts haunting here and there all the time. The Adelaide Room is believed to be the most active, with keys being moved and footsteps being heard. The location has been featured on the panorama show Psychic Kids. Number 3. El Dabalo Cemetery. Located in Cumberland, Rhode Island, the cemetery is one of the creepiest around with its crypts and old tombstones. Once home to a religious meeting house, the cemetery today has been heavily vandalized. However, all forms of panorama activity have been reported. Voices have been heard, shadow figures have been seen, and UFOs have been reported in the nearby field. This is quite unbelievable, but true. Number 2. Escape Here's Haunted Victorian Mansion. Ghost Hunters, Ghost Adventures, and My Ghost Stories have all featured this 1825 mansion located in Gardner, Massachusetts. It was once the crown jewel for millionaire escapees, but time has taken its toll on the location. Many spirits are said to haunt the mansion, some friendly and others not so much. Children have been seen running around and furniture on the top floors have moved. The activity has become so bad that the current owners no longer live there. Number 1. The Lizzie Borden House. On August 4, 1892, this house in Fall River, Massachusetts, was the site of two brutal murders of the Abbey and Andrew Borden that captivated the nation. Andrew's daughter, Lizzie, was charged but later acquitted for the murders. Now, her home is a bed and breakfast spot and is New England's most famous haunted spot. Guests have reported seeing a woman standing at the edge of their bed and others have been touched. It has been featured on many television shows and has become a must-see place for ghost seekers. There you have it, guys. We don't always feature ghost stories in our videos, but this one was worth the catch. So tell us what you think in the comment section. Thanks for watching. If you did enjoy this video, do not forget to like and drop a comment, and also subscribe and share with your friends.